Oh, hi, Sage.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
That's what we like to call a segue.
Mr. Echo Fox the Kill Sage, who's returning to his old main, his old Brawl main, Snake.
Yeah, and Vivi returning to his old Smash 4 main, Lucario.
Man, that game is so old, I can't even remember at this point.
Which one came first? I don't even remember.
Yeah.
So Lucario in this game he's different than he was in Smash 4. Mm. He feels overall more balanced, which kind of hurts him.
Yeah.
He had a really strong gimmick in Smash 4. Vivi never really played to that gimmick, so I'm curious to see how his ultimate Lucario will play out.
Yeah,
right.
And this is a match that Lucario probably never had to face. Well, he actually never faced it in Smash 4. So the thing about this matchup is, I feel like Snake can tank a bunch of hits right now, and he could probably kill Lucario earlier than you think he would. He still has the crazy up tilt that he did have in Brawl.
Doesn't have the same hitbox, though.
Not same hitbox, the same knockback stream. So, right on cue. And with the new dash mechanics, you can do run-up up tilt, so it's something you could probably catch people off surprise with, just like Vivi in that scenario.
Yeah, I actually am curious to see how Vivi uses Lucario's normals, because his tilts were always pretty good, and I wonder how useful they'll be.
He definitely tried to counter that to get in on the kill stage a little bit. Didn't work out for him. But right now, it seems like Vivi is just trying to find a way to get in. And that double parry, just so you know, when you parry one hit, the next parry comes automatically. So it's not like he manually inputs all those parries. But it's still
cool. It's not Evo 37.
Yeah, no, it's still cool to see, though. Five frame window, by the way.
But I thought it was 4 frames.
Five.
It's five. Okay, yeah. Cool to know. Speaking of that mechanic, those projectile characters are a lot in the infancy of this game. They're so hard to deal with. Because as a player who's played Smash for all these years, you're used to just power shielding everything. But now you can't do that. Ooh, yeah. Sage.
And I don't know if you're seeing what the Kill Sage is doing right now. So Vivi has been running. He's been putting Vivi in scenarios where he's putting a bomb in between, rolling behind Vivi, and having to deal with an explosive and an up tilt coming to his face. Like, Sage right now is like on a different level of Mensa.
And this is the sort of thing where, like, if you had never really seen Snake at a competitive level before, and he's been absent for quite some time, you don't even know what's going on.
Yeah. You're
just explosive, all these little ways, the mines. It's just fantastic to see the mastery already with this game having been out so just barely any time ago. Sage is just really working.
Yeah, I mean, if you're a Smash reviewer, you could probably closely relate this to something like Duck Hunt. Duck Hunt is another character who like sets up these traps, sets up these bombs, gimmicks to try to trap you, put you in situations that you don't want to be in. Put you in a situation where you're literally between a bomb and a guy with a big foot.
Yeah, except imagine if Duck Hunt had the kill power of a grizzled old veteran.
It's like imagine if Duck Hunt was Liam Neeson.
Oh, and, again.
Yeah. That attack, okay, so in Brawl, that attack wasn't as useful as it is right now. There's less cooldown on that move than there was in Brawl, and it's freer in this game.
Oh, yeah, and you can see Vivi has that instinct to recover low, because there are all these projectiles coming at him. Mm-hmm. But he just says, it's a little emissary,
Yeah,
in the movie, there's the guy and he hides behind the corner and he's like, I'm safe. And then there's like the jump scare of the missile is right behind him.
Yep. Mm-hmm. The jump scare, you see you get stabbed in the back like 2 seconds later. It's definitely what happened to Vivi just now. And it doesn't help that the lightning effects that you see in this game are a little bit exaggerated. So.
Yeah. Oh, I love it. It really feels like Nintendo trying to make it more spectator friendly just by having more explosions.
Yeah. But so the kill site is trying to do that Brawl thing that Snake has. So Snake will put you down on the ground, and then he'll set you up for a tech chase. So he's trying to get that dash tag check chase just in case Vivi rolls away, or he might try to get wake up on grab and just grab Vivi out of it. So
you could kind of tell that Vivi might not be so familiar with just the way that Snake sets up his traps. And I mean, I'm having trouble keeping track of it myself.
Wow! Well, he covered. he set up the bomb just to backer him. Still, it's ridiculous. Yes, more Brawl things, man. It's beautiful to see that all those things are completely intact for Snake's game plan.
How long has this game been out? He's covering all of these options at the same time.
I mean, more or less, it's the same character. Just a slightly different. I mean, a very different engine, just a different engine than in Brawl.
Yeah, the engine seems to do well for him overall. The increased speed will... at least the way it is right now. Maybe increased speed down the line will mean it'll be less effective for him to set up all these traps because characters might just be able to get in on him. But for now, it's so fast that we don't even know when the next explosion is coming.
Right now, and Sage is doing this thing again. Like, he's pretty much putting... Every time BB responds, he puts himself in the air and drops a whole bunch of bombs, knowing that BB's probably going to approach him. And BB is actually trapping himself in the process. And, you know, that's the thing. Like, he's literally setting down these bombs just in case he could grab him or, like, roll away. And, you know, it's kind of tough for Vivi to get in right now.
Vivi is trying to... I love the way that he's putting those bombs on those platforms. Vivi has been trying to shark him with up airs, with forward airs. And by putting the bombs there, he's actually, you know, that situation has been turned around on him.
Yeah, and I think... I think the thing that BB is running into right now is, like, he's trying to get in on Snake knowing that Snake's trying to zone him. But with him running in recklessly like that, he's actually setting up what Sage wants him to do. He wants him to run inside. He wants to grab him and throw him into bombs. He wants him to get tech chase situations just like that.
And you know how I said earlier that, like, there's this intensity in a primal form? You can see frustration so clearly. The way that BB has been, like, running into these moves. You know, when you're unfamiliar with the game as a whole and all of a sudden you're facing off against this, like, you know, let's not forget, DaKillSage is one of the best fighting game players in the world.
Yeah.
And so he is already, you know, with experience in this game, you can tell that BB is just...
He feels
hurt. And
the thing that you have to remember, even though the game is faster as a whole, like characters move faster, jump faster, and everything like that, doesn't mean you have to run into everything. There's also a time to take it slow. And I think Vivi just, you know, ran into a whole bunch of things. Like, there's no shame in walking. There's no shame in, like, taking a pause and just viewing your landscape as a whole. Because right now, like, what just happened was Vivi was running into him, and pretty much Sage just grabbing him and throwing him into bombs.